Smilodon is one of the best-known prehistoric animals. It has a ferocious reputation with its long upper canines protruding from its mouth, its powerful, muscular body, and its ability to take down the likes of mammoths. But could this impressive carnivore have lived alongside dinosaurs during the Mesozoic era? Three species of Smilodon lived during the Pleistocene. Smilodon gracilis and Smilodon populator were found in South America, and Smilodon fatalis was found in North America. They all belonged to an extinct subfamily of Felidae. They lived during the Pleistocene, from 2.5 million years ago until 10,000 years ago. This was a period in Earth's history that was renowned for being relatively cool. Expansive ice sheets formed at the poles, spreading across much of North America, Eurasia, and into South America. There was a huge amount of climatic fluctuation between glacial and interglacial periods during the Pleistocene. Towards the end of the era, 18,000 years ago, the Earth was plunged into one of its many ice ages. During this time, around a third of the planet was covered in glaciers. This was a stark contrast to the conditions of the Mesozoic era, in which the dinosaurs roamed the Earth and dominated the landscape. Smilodon, often referred to as the saber-toothed tiger, was adapted to the cold conditions of the Pleistocene. It was covered in thick fur to keep it warm. It had large paws to help it walk through deep snow. Its tail was short and stubby to reduce heat loss. And it had a large body size. Although they were about a foot shorter than today's lions, they weighed twice as much, allowing them to conserve body heat in the harsh climate of the Pleistocene. The Mesozoic, however, was a much warmer time in Earth's history. It spanned the time between 250 million years ago and 66 million years ago. It was divided into the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods, the time of the dinosaurs. These large reptiles ruled the world and were adapted to the hotter climes of the Mesozoic. Pangaea broke up, and the land masses that would ultimately become today's continents separated and began moving into the positions they are found in today. Before its breakup, the vastness of Pangaea created large deserts in its center. It was a hot, dry, and unforgiving place. But as the huge supercontinent broke up, the deserts retreated, and the smaller land masses were surrounded by water, which increased the humidity of the land. Vegetation began to take hold in the form of conifers and cycads. The sea levels rose as rifts formed in the ocean, and the seafloor spread upwards and outwards. The massive amount of geological movement during the early Mesozoic released large quantities of carbon dioxide. This increased the global temperatures even more by creating a greenhouse effect. It is likely that in the conditions of the Mesozoic, Smilodon would have overheated. There were no large mammals during this time as the reptiles dominated the landscape. The mammals that were around were small and shrew-like. Smilodon conserved energy by adapting its hunting technique as an ambush predator. They didn't pursue their prey over long distances. Instead, they pounced on it, using their powerful forelimbs to cling on. So, Smilodon have been able to survive on a diet of dinosaurs. While some dinosaurs were indeed enormous, like the mighty Gigantosaurus that stood 13 meters or 43 feet long, there were smaller specimens that Smilodon could have hunted. In the Pleistocene, they commonly took down bison, giant ground sloths, and mammoths, although the mammoths were more often juveniles or babies. Whilst today's big cats often use their teeth to grip their prey and hold on whilst bringing it to the ground, Smilodon's canines are prone to breaking. Instead, they had incredibly powerful forelegs. They would use these to swipe their prey down or to cling on, relying on their body weight to tire the animal. Once it was brought to the ground, Smilodon could deliver its fatal bites with its long canines. These were likely in the form of slicing or stabbing motions, rather than the slow, suffocating behavior typically used by today's wildcats. Originally, Smilodon was thought to pursue prey across the open grasslands, but new evidence now suggests that they were ambush predators. This relied on them hiding in the undergrowth and behind trees. Unlike some other cats, Smilodon was not thought to be a good climber and preferred to hunt solely on the ground. The early Mesozoic era was sparsely populated with vegetation. Although there were conifer forests, there may not have been enough ground cover for Smilodon to hide behind when searching for a meal. Grasses didn't become widespread until the late Cretaceous period, Only then would Smilodon have been able to conceal itself in long grass. But that's not to say that the Mesozoic was so bare that there was no vegetation to hide behind. The ambush style of hunting suited some dinosaurs at that time. Velociraptors and Utah raptors were not as fast as some of the other dinosaurs. Instead, they relied on the element of surprise. They had strong, muscular hind legs, used for pouncing onto their unsuspecting prey. They hid behind vegetation during the Cretaceous period, waiting for the opportune moment to strike. Some scientists suggest that Smilodon was a social animal. They believed that they could have hunted in prides or packs like today's lions. This would have meant that during the Mesozoic era, they could have taken down large dinosaurs together and were at a lower risk of becoming injured during the attack. Due to an abundance of fossils found in tar pits alongside prey species, it is thought that Smilodon responded to the distress calls of prey animals, a behavior that favors sociality. Many fossilized remains bear scars from significant injuries that occurred long before the animal died. This means that Smilodon was able to survive such injuries and continue to thrive afterward. This led scientists to believe that Smilodon could rely on other pack members for food and safety, whilst it recovered from an injury. However, more recent research has pointed towards a mere solitary lifestyle for Smilodon. The size of their brains was not conducive to the complexity of social behavior. Furthermore, modern-day big cats heal quickly without the help of members of their species, and this could explain how Smilodon healed and was able to survive following a potentially lethal conflict. It is now believed that Smilodon was, in fact, a solitary animal only coming together to mate and look after young. Although the carnivorous lifestyle of Smilodon fits well with the many different dinosaur species that preyed on others, we don't think that Smilodon could have survived the Mesozoic era. Smilodon were known to be specialists in their niche, a trait that probably led to their demise at the Pleistocene-Holocene boundary. However, not all animals became extinct at the end of the Pleistocene. Some, such as bears, went on to thrive in today's world. However, these species were highly adaptable. One characteristic of bears is that they can eat a wide range of food from meat to sedges, nuts, and berries. This put them in good stead for changes to the environment and conditions around them. But Smilodon was too specialized in their hunting strategies. When prey species dried up towards the end of the Pleistocene, they were unable to adapt and survive. Similarly, some species such as wolves and coyotes became smaller to cope with limited prey and a changing environment. Smilodon did not make this kind of transformation. During the Mesozoic era, there were huge shifts in the climate and the geography of the planet. An enormous amount of change meant that the animals living at the time had to adapt or die. The mammals around during the Mesozoic were inhibited from evolving and diversifying due to the presence and domination of the reptiles. Once the dinosaurs died out, the mammals were able to branch out into the vast array of different species that grace our planet today. Three of the five largest mass extinctions that we know about happened during the Mesozoic. Many of the Earth species were wiped out, and it is unlikely that Smilodon would have survived where others couldn't. We believe that Smilodon was powerful enough to take down dinosaurs to feed upon, and would put up a significant fight if they were ever preyed upon themselves. However, the climatic conditions of the Mesozoic were too different from the Pleistocene. Their adaptations to cope with the cold would have hampered their survival during the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. For these reasons, we don't think that Smilodon could have survived the Mesozoic era. That's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. You can also leave a comment with what you would like to see in the following videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time.